Our two nations are forever joined together by the spirit of revolution and the fight for freedom. France is America's first and oldest ally. A lot of people don't know that. Today we face new threats from rogue regimes like North Korea, Iran, and Syria, and the governments that finance and support them. We also face grave threats from terrorist organizations that wage war on innocent lives. Tomorrow will mark 1 year since a joyous Bastille Day celebration in Nice turned into a massacre. We also renew our resolve to stand united against these enemies of humanity and to strip them of their territory, their funding, their networks, and ideological support. Today, President Macron and myself discussed how we can strengthen our vital security partnerships. The United States and our allies strengthen our commitments to defeat terrorism. We're also making tremendous progress. Earlier this week, with the strong support of the United States and the global coalition, Iraq forces liberated the city of Mosul from ISIS control. Now we must work with the government of Iraq and our partners and allies in the region to consolidate the gains and ensure that the victory stays a victory. Last week, the G20 leaders also reaffirmed the right to sovereign nations to control their borders. We must be strong from within to defend ourselves from threats from the outside. The nations of the West also face domestic challenges of our own creation, including vast government bureaucracy that saps the strength from our economies and from our societies. We must also confront unfair trade practices that hurt our workers and pursue trade deals that are reciprocal and fair. The United States remains committed to being a leader in environmental protection while we advance energy security and economic growth.